Hey everyone, Corey from Aquarium Co-op. Today's a fish room tour with Bob. Stick around, we got African cichlids, we got planet tanks, we got all kinds of stuff. You never know what you're going to see in the corner, so we're going to get started over there, I think. Maybe the planet tank? Let's take a look. All right, so we've got a 40 breeder here. Tell me what's in it, tell me how it started, tell me all your disasters, that type of thing.
Well, there's lots of disasters throughout the process of this tank. It's always been planted, and I'm to the point now where I just let it grow. I don't care what grows in there. I used to aquascape it, but I don't anymore. It's just too clustered. Too many plants over that long period of time, so now I just let whatever grows, grows.
Sure. And then, what were you telling me this was again up here? Because I didn't know this plant.
Crypt Wallisii. I don't know if I'm
pronouncing it right. I don't know that you're pronouncing it right, but I know exactly what you're talking about, so that's fine. And then, I know what you're doing here, but explain this to people, that red stuff?
Basically, the blackbeard algae that I put hydrogen peroxide on.
And do you do that, like, did you target it that with a syringe or something, or?
Yeah, I use a pipette.
Okay.
And then I just dab it wherever it needs it.
And, like, how much do you put, like, would you fill that whole pipette
I'll fill this whole thing up for just that section.
Okay. And then you did that, what, like yesterday or something? Yep. Or?
So I did it yesterday, then it turns red, and then a day later it'll be gone.
Nice. Yeah, that's how you target, you know, with hydrogen peroxide. And, you know, officially we don't endorse this, but yes, we both do and it works for us. So don't come crying if you kill something with hydrogen peroxide. But
I think that's what killed off my Monte Carlo, because I used to spray it, spot treat the Monte Carlo.
Yeah.
Now it won't carpet anymore.
There's another guy that actually did it with Excel, I think, but it totally burned out his carpet. So, yeah, you got to be a little careful what you do it with.
So now I'm waiting for it to regrow.
And what are these guys that are kind of hiding out in here?
Nanochromis splendens.
Yeah, I've never seen them kind of not in a pet store where they're actually loving life. There's a female back there, you know, in this maze of awesome plants. Yeah, you can see it travel, and then it looks like, I think you said earlier this was a sunset crypt, or a
Florida sunset.
Yeah, that thing is awesome.
The one in the back plant is AR pink.
Oh,
most
yeah, okay.
It's purple, but that's the pink form.
And is that the same plant on the right-hand side that's just not getting as much light, so it's not pink, or?
The small.
Oh, okay,
the
small, yeah, the
one
small,
down there,
yeah.
That's a Laquidia of some sort, the
okay.
Taller ones.
And
but the smaller ones are the AR.
And for those of you that don't know what AR is, that should be Alternanthera wernickii, right? Is that true?
That's true. I
don't know if I said it right, but.
That's why I didn't say it.
Yeah. Okay, and then.
See, this is the problem I have in this tank. You see there's stargrass. But I haven't had stargrass in there for like 6 months.
Right in the back there, yeah.
But when I tear it down and replant it, there's always roots in there and it always grows back.
Hmm.
So now I just don't even try.
And then where did these rainbows come from?
Those are actually from Gary Lang.
Yeah, that looks so good.
F1's purchased at auction.
Are they a Treyu line or is that? I'm trying
Lake
to.
And.
ATRYU or something like that. Yeah, okay.
Like,
so it's that line. Because they've got that kind of that better color on the back half of them than just a normal Boswani. It's more of a red or orange, deep orange, I think.
They call them the retailers call them a red form, but
it's
orange. I don't know, everything's red in America.
And we've got the infinite willow hydro back here where some more nanochromis are hanging out.
Yeah, I just trimmed it, so it's a lot of roots.
Oh, I didn't realize. So you're injecting CO2. I guess I didn't see that many plants that would require the CO2, so I didn't think about that.
Yeah. These are the Lortoensis corydoras.
Yeah, I like those guys. I've got them in my store. They don't sell very well. I sold, like, all of them to you originally, and then I brought some in. Yeah. What pressure do you have to run on this diffuser? Because isn't it kind of sensitive or, like, higher pressure or something like that for that one?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay. So
I had a glass diffuser. I put that on. I didn't change it at all. So.
Oh, okay. So there's some of those that like, if it's not exactly 42 PSI, like this thing doesn't work.
Well, you can see how many bubbles I'm pumping into it. If it's light enough.
Oh, yeah.
I'm blasting it.
Yeah, it's going pretty good. And then you got your sweet $3,000 cancer filter here.
Yeah.
The Odyssey something or other.
That's exactly it. I think it said that on the box.
Yeah. The awesome part And it's like totally an Eheim knockoff. Like it's totally got Eheimish stuff
it's
and
the
pose.
Same company
and...
that makes the FX6 knockoff.
Okay. I haven't played with one of those. I guess I own stores, so I don't, you know, I get a better deal, but I haven't played with any of those. I should. But even as a check valve. Nice. Alright, we can move on. What's down low here? I'll get down low in the... Oh, no, not cichlids.
Those are shellies, obviously.
Yep. Are these multis?
Yep.
Yeah, multifasciatus.
And Paracyprichromis blue neon.
Those things are rad. I think they... You know, the what I don't like about the Paracyps is I feel like they only look absolutely amazing when you light them from the side.
Yeah,
like,
I don't
if you
have
get sunlight on them or...
I don't have very good lighting on them, that's for sure. To bring out their color. I mean, if I pull this all the way forward, and then they get under it and face a certain way,
right.
You can see the neon.
And I think you get that when you... Let me see if I can do it. If we light it from... Oh, now I scared them all. Now I've done it. Yeah, so when you light them from the side,
yeah,
you can really start seeing that blue neon that we're talking about. And, you know, I think... I want to do this fish in a pond, like, super bad, because I think if sunlight hitting it, it'd become, like, my new favorite fish, but... Yeah, I've never kept this fish. I want to. I probably should buy some fry or something because I love this. I'm surprised that these multis aren't beaten down on the Paracyps.
No, the only time they come to the upper part is when I'm standing here for food. So they think they're getting food right now. Otherwise, they stay.
So the Paracyps always stay up top then?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, because I was thinking they probably use the cave structure back there, but I was like, if they come down, those guys are gonna beat on them. Yeah.
They used to have a nice rock formation. They actually just dug it out. You can see the rocks that don't have algae. So they're always moving them around. I don't know how those little fish can move those rocks, but...
That's the best part of the multis is they're always changing it. You don't get to tell them what to do. They tell you what they're going to do. But yeah, this is... Is that the Senex sand? Is that what that is?
Yep.
Yeah, so when you guys hear me in the live stream talk about Senex sand, that type of stuff, this is what we're talking about. You can get it from some... local gravel yards and stuff. Obviously, I have no idea if places local to you can get it. And if you really need some, I can sell you online, but shipping substrates is a bad idea. It's going to cost you an arm and a leg, so that's why I don't have it on there. But it is the best stuff. I always say it's the best. It's my favorite. I think this one's a little bit finer than what I normally use.
This is a mix of number two and number one.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was going to say, I use a little bit coarser, but I love it. It comes pre-washed, too. That's the biggest perk.
Yeah, I take it out of the bag, straight into the tank.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's... My wife's gonna see this tank and be like, we should do that again, because I used to run lots of multis. And then there's another good idea here. So from the stand, this is the Lowe's double 40 breeder stand, but the sliders look like they're holding up.
Yep.
That's, you know, I didn't do that on my carpet, which it was fine, but people ask me all the time, like, what do you put underneath? And I go, I don't know, something. But now, let's buy some sliders, apparently.
Well, it makes it, because I can lower it to about 25%, and you can actually slide this to where you want it to go. Not that that's good to move a tank when there's water in it. But.
You mean you don't move it around like every day? Like, oh, I want to see you over here today. Every water change, it's a different place. Yeah, that guy was starting to show his blue off from the side. That, yeah, the Paracyps.
I took out the dominant male about a week ago, so I think they're starting to go through that process.
That you did, I guess you probably know that, but they've got albino versions of these. I've never seen one in person, though.
I've never seen one either. I want to get one to mix in.
I want to know, like, is it way cooler or is it less color? Like, I have no idea, but I know I want to see one. Because this is a fish for me. It's either the best fish I've ever seen or the worst fish I've ever seen, depending on the light. Like, it's either a brown turd or it's the most beautiful fish. There's no in between. It's not like, oh, it looks okay. It's either, or, oh my God. This is why, if I build a greenhouse, I'm keeping that fish in there. Because I think sunlight would do it awesome. So, I'm trying to think what else we got up in here. Just some neons, those corys we saw.
Cristilla, there's pygmy corys. There's one Siamese algae eater.
You can see, so when you see the bubbles rising up, by the way, that's because the plants are purling because they're happy. So, yeah, you can see it coming off the crypts and stuff. Those are all oxygen bubbles. Do you have a... Is it on a solenoid so the CO2 turns off when the lights go out?
Yeah, it only runs for 6 hours a day and the lights are 8 hours.
And I guess we should talk about lighting. Let me get up here. So, this is, in my opinion, a lot of light on a 40 breeder. We got
a ton of light.
What, two planted pluses? Is that what they are? No, or is it... Yeah, it's two planted pluses. And then the center one's a monster ray?
Yep, and I just took off a ray 2, so I used to have 4.
Good lord, how is that not like... That's a lot of lighting.
Well, I was using that to try to really get some growth out of this after I killed it all, but...
Uh-huh.
After 2 weeks, I ended up with this on the glass, so I took it off.
Do you know what causes the green spot algae? I mean, I know what the internet says, and it's about almost any different thing, but I've never been able to find a direct correlation like this made this. Is it just an imbalance of nutrients, or was it more light?
I don't know. Maybe I'm just lucky, but I'll get it on this lobelia.
Uh-huh.
And if I dump, like, potassium, it'll go away.
Okay. So maybe it's a potassium deficiency, maybe? Yeah.
It's generally not a problem. I don't care if it's on the glass. So.
What kind of pH does this tank run when the CO2 is running in there? Any idea?
We can find out real quick.
Sure. I was wondering, like, well, it's, you know, you got, is it some ADA soil mixed in there too, or is it
This is the Mr. Aqua soil.
Okay.
There's fluoride, there's the Eco Complete.
A little mix of everything, sure.
Well, maybe I can't.
Uh-oh, the internet's going to hate you because you do what I do, the test strips. I'm the only, like, white knight on the internet vouching for these things. I swear to God. Like, everyone just goes, oh, how do I love you, Corey, and how do you use these? Are you retarded? And I go, yep, I'm retarded. I trust my life and business to them.
Dude, when I had 3 tanks, I would do the API, but...
Yeah, now we can see all kinds of things here real quick. Yeah, we're running down low, like 6.2-ish, something like that. Yeah, we're low. Which I expected it to be low. Alkalinity is all right. Probably got to dose a decent amount of nitrogen in there to keep these plants growing. How often you got to trim this thing?
I trim it every week.
And what size tank is this?
125.
125, okay. 4-foot lights, dark on one end.
This is where all the plecos hang out, so I don't light it.
Oh, that's kind of a smart idea, actually.
The only way I see them is if I don't light it.
Huh, I'll make sure I get over there and see if I can see some. But obviously, well, I say obviously, but maybe not to everyone, rainbowfish tank. What type is this guy? Do we know?
Parkinsonia.
Okay.
Or Port Mosby, sometimes they call it that.
I've seen that, yeah. And the females, the problem with rainbows in general, females usually aren't that cool.
There's the female, one of them.
Yeah.
Just the silver fish.
Yeah.
But I find you get more color if you throw females in there, the males color it better.
Oh, for sure. I think the same way with African cichlids, I think.
The rainbow shiners in there, too. Fish you don't see very often. I think you have some.
Oh, yeah. I saw them from across the room, and I was thinking, I wonder what shiner that is. But, yeah, I've actually got a bunch of these growing out in a pond. And what you guys...
Some of them are getting...
What you guys don't know yet is that fish, once it gets about 4 inches, that blue really comes out, turns into a purple. It's pretty much amazing. And it just takes, like, 2 years for that color to come out is the problem. You got quite a few of them.
10 of them.
Yeah, that's no joke. That's not a cheap fish either.
Nope.
Like, in Europe and stuff, they were going for $20+ a piece for a while.
There's a Paracyprichromis you don't see very often. We probably won't see the male, but that's the female. It's a Rubrolabiatus something or other.
Huh. I was going to say, like, you know, I was like, that guy looks good. And then I have to remember, oh, Teniata species, like, oh, that's a female. The females always look better. Oh, there's a pleco there. What is that guy? Is this just a bristle nose, maybe a female? Or no, it's a... I can see his tail, too. I'm horrible with remembering their names.
I can't see enough of it.
Yeah, right in his... You can see, like, right in there, it's got, like, the leopard print tail.
Oh, the para?
Yeah.
Para pleco?
Yep. The para.
There's a L91. You can see the tail.
Oh, yeah.
Not the tail, but...
Yeah, the dorsal and the tail, he's hiding. It's always hard to do the fisherman videos when without spending all day going, oh, yeah, we can see that guy over there. Go get him. But no, I like the fact that you leave, you know, the third section dim. That's actually a smart idea because it allows everything to hide out if they want. Like, you never see anyone do that. I don't think I've ever done a fisherman where someone intentionally left one side dark. Like, I feel like if I owned that tank, it would drive me nuts. I'd be like, oh, I gotta light it.
It took me a while to like it, but now that I actually see my fish, I like it a lot more.
And this is a rare fish here. Is that the mascara barb?
Yep.
Is that what that is? Yeah. You don't see those very often. And then always the super rare elusive baller shark.
That was one of my first fish, so...
He's a little guy.
I know.
You dwarfed him.
I did somehow. I don't know. He's been in here almost his whole life, so... I don't know how.
Have you had this tank that long? Like, how long... I thought you were... How long have you been in the hobby?
2 years.
2 years. For some reason... I feel like I've known you for longer than 2 years, so that's why I was thinking. I think I thought it was like 4 or 5, but yeah. So obviously addicted then. At 2 years, you're up to this. What do we got in this tank? Another 40 breeder.
This one is actually, you wouldn't know, but mostly plecos and corys.
Oh, I can see what. Yeah.
The blue phantom.
Yeah, there's a green phantom, I think, or at least
green
another,
or blue,
yeah,
blue, whatever.
And these rad corys, like, I don't know what they are off the top of my head, but they got that nice sail fin to them. And they're some of the biggest ones I've seen in here. Like, they're meaty if they come out. Like, there's another one. Yeah, the guy that just came out, probably a female. That thing. Have you had him breed at all yet?
No. But I haven't really tried either, so.
Yeah. And then there's that guy back there. That's a fish. I've never seen that fish in person besides here. And what was it, the pseudo crabulatus?
No, pulse,
yeah. I don't know how to say it, but yeah.
Pseudo crenlabiatus.
There you go. You sounded like a pro. Yeah, those corys are bananas. Glare's getting them, but I think that might be my favorite thing so far, because who doesn't love a giant corydora?
The guy just chilling on the pot.
Mm-hmm.
So there's the phantom plecos, there's mega clown plecos, and there's leopard frog plecos.
Ooh, leopard frog's my favorite. I haven't seen it in here, but I already know it's my favorite.
There's four of them, but I only see them when I come out here at midnight with a flashlight.
You should sell them to me. Oh man, where are they? They're the coolest fish.
There's usually one has his head poking out of the pot in the back, but I don't see it now.
Yeah, of course. Well, they never do it for camera. They know what's up. They're not dumb. And then this is all sponge filter in this tank? Is that what we're filtering with?
Yep.
And then looks like crips and bulbitis. Is this more lobelia?
Yep.
How do I not know that plant? I feel like that's... Like, I was going to call it, like, Laderni or something over there, but... I don't know why I don't know that plant. Does it never get sold, like, commercially? I'm trying to think. Lobelia cardinalis plant? Is it the it's supposed to be... Okay, I'm thinking of it. When it comes in from commercial, it'll be purple or red.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it has really long, weird-looking leaves.
Yeah, okay. And now, that's why I was like, man, I just don't know that plant, but I never have kept that plant. I've only ever sold it as the red plant or purple or whatever, so...
And there's a mini and a regular form.
Huh. I didn't know that. God, look at that. Look at that guy. I'm jealous of that guy. Well, I'm jealous of those guys in particular, like... To scale, you guys don't know that those stirbite corys are already 2 feet long, so that makes those guys like 6 feet.
Feet?
That's right, feet. They're huge. They're literally like, I don't have anything to scale, but, you know.
We get a banana.
Yeah, we need a banana. Like, that thing is huge, like, no doubt. Like, and there's a group of them, too. Like, that's... I'm jealous of that. This is, like, the most Gary Lang tank I've ever seen. Because this, when I toured his fish room, this is exactly how he would do his rainbows. So, what type of rainbow is that?
Multi-squamata. I don't know if I said it right.
Yeah, I don't know that rainbow.
Lepis multi-squamata.
Yeah, yeah.
Just turn a nice bronze reddish as they get older. And we'll have the longer fins. Fins, obviously, it's the gloss.
Right, right. Yeah, that's pretty neat. And you got lots of anubias. And then, is that mini form of bulbitis?
Could be. I don't know to tell you.
Staying pretty small there, so. But I feel like you could take this tank and put it in Gary Lang's fish room and it would fit right in. Like, this is, it's always like a few, like, low light plants and then, like, a group of rainbows. Oh, and some stirbies.
Yeah.
Have you been breeding the stirbies or?
No, there's a Reynoldsi, too. There's a couple of those in there. Reynoldsi, I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, and what's that cichlid? Is that...
That's another Nanochromis. It was sold to me as Consortus.
Uh-huh.
But I haven't been able to get that verified by anyone. It's a pretty rare fish, so I don't know if that's actually what it is.
Maybe YouTube can do that for you. Hopefully that footage, someone can go, I am the Nanochromis expert, and that is or isn't this.
But nice. There's a pair of them in there.
Nice. It's kind of weird. Is it the females that kind of have that snakeskin pattern on the rainbows?
I don't know if they're...
Like, only some of them have it, yeah.
It's one or the other. I don't... It looks like the males don't have it, now that you pointed it out.
Yeah, I don't know. So...
Oh.
How big is it? How big is this tank?
75 gallon.
And then start labeling fish, because I can see a lot of different things in here.
So you have the Cichlid utinta.
Okay.
There's actually a blackfin that got in there that I need to take out next time I do a water change.
Ooh, yeah. How'd it get in there? Like,
I'm thinking...
Like, was it a baby that grew up, or...?
Well, I've had fish go from tank to tank when I have the python in there. So I don't know if I got in the hose, and then... Yeah, that's the only thing I can think of.
Yeah.
I got a couple bristlenose plecos, some cleanup duty. These are the gold shellies.
Yeah, the ocelotus, yeah.
And then yellow, I believe, calvis.
Hmm. These guys are like the slowest growing things on the planet.
Yep. Some julies, a couple of julies in there. There's actually, I don't know the name, because it's only a scientific name, but there's the goby, the lake tank goby in there somewhere.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They call them a clown goby sometimes, and itramistia something, you know, yeah.
But he's always under something, so I usually only see him when I piss him off doing the water changes.
I want to breed those pretty bad, actually. Yeah. Also, lupi.
Yep.
Yellow lupis.
And I think that's it.
Yeah.
It's weird. Most of the plecos, they'll hang out on the rock. I've never really seen them leave the rock.
It looks like we've got fry up here. These are...
You tend to.
Nice. And do you just put the pot in there for cover, or...?
Yeah, because what I'll do is I'll take the female out and put her in there and let her spit. I don't...
Okay.
Her.
Yeah. That's
and
pretty
then,
smart.
Yeah, so they have a place to hide. Although I've never had them eat them.
Yeah, I haven't experienced that much, but...
I still like to give them a place to hide.
Yeah, I think it's easier to raise them that way, too, when they're, you know, up top, separated. Looks like we got some Val and Java Fern and Anubias, all easy stuff.
Yep.
And is this, looks like two tanks down here?
Yep, 220 gallon.
What do we got going on down here? More of my favorite sand, by the way, in all these tanks.
That's Cichlid Speckleback Moba.
Must be new to you, kind of smallish, or are those raised out? Okay.
I've had them about a month.
Okay. It's awesome. I'm jealous because Cichlids are expensive and hard to ship, and I don't take a chance very often on those.
Yeah, I get them from a place in Arizona.
And yeah, I want to see this tank over here because that's a 20 gallon, I believe. And then this tank over here has got these rainbows that I've never seen before. And I love it when I see fish I've never seen before. They're a dwarf rainbow, and we've both forgotten the name, but I've seen them on the list, but that thing is amazing. How long have you had them?
Maybe 3-4 months.
All right, so no idea if they're full grown yet, but they're getting the humps on them and stuff. Like, you know, they're definitely maturing out, but I've never seen that fish before, and I feel like a lesser human being for it. And now I gotta track some down, because there's nothing worse than when I see something I like and I don't own it. I really gotta try to get it, so...
I should have been prepared better and had a name for you.
Well, that makes it a little harder. I'll just email you and ask you. Be like, what were those? Are those super red bristlenose?
Yep, those are from Barbie.
Oh, okay, the Pleco Queen, yeah. Nice.
There's 3 females and 1 male.
Any action for you yet?
No, the male actually just started going in that tube and fanning.
Nice.
A week or two ago, so hopefully not much longer.
Yeah, shouldn't be too long. So,
75.
Yep. I'm starting to think, like, what's not in this tank?
There comes the, Brichardi.
Oh, wow. You don't see that Cynodontis very often.
It's one of my favorite.
I'm in love with, I think you had the Petricola somewhere.
I love
Petricolas, yeah. It's neat. Any breeding from them yet?
No. Well, not that, I mean...
Right. Not that you've seen or whatever. Yeah, wow, there's a lot of those.
There's a... I have a pair of bristlenose plecos in there that breed all the time. Free fish food.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm trying to think. I love the smallest sponge filter you owns in this tank. I mean, there's other ones too, but I just find that funny.
It's tall, at least.
Is it?
Yeah, that's all.
Wow, that is like the tallest sponge filter ever. I just thought it was on top of the rocks. That's why I was giving you hell.
Those are the ones from Gemco that are stackable.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the ATIs. These guys want to eat. They're just wanting to be on camera. Yeah, this is... I'm excited to see the Tretts not beating stuff down, these guys. Like, I just... The internet would tell you, like, that you'd be missing an arm right now from these guys, so...
Yep, that's what everyone told me, but I haven't seen it yet. And they're big. They're full-grown adults.
Yeah. So I'm kind of excited for that, because I like that fish. I mean, I like it because I basically get my frontosa feel without having to have a giant tank. So maybe I'll play with some of those.
And there's five or six of them in there.
Of course, the ones I get will just be hell, but, you know, I don't get it.
I grew all these fish from fry together, so that's probably what helped.
I didn't realize. You do have some live plants. These are some, like, wonder bulbs or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
From your store.
Nice. I can't even get these anymore. It's a real pain because they grow so well and get people started into plants, but...
It's kind of frustrating that they grow and it looks really good and then they all just die.
Yeah.
A couple months later, here they come again.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny.
And then for filtration, you got, like, what is this? This is peace lily? Is that what that is?
What is that thing?
Pothos. Okay, it's a different form than I'm used to, but that's a buttload of it. Yeah. With the sunlight from the window, that's just efficient right there. Oh man, are we using like ADA substrate for this plant?
Yep.
Like this guy's a big baller over here. I'm getting all the way down, so I'm getting good.
This is a Heterandria formosa.
Ooh, I got that fish too. I like that fish.
Yep. There's orange shrimp in there.
The red ram's horns, apparently. It's good color on that guy. It's like a different form than the ones I have, I feel like.
Yeah, I've never seen one look like that.
Wait, what's this guy? Is that a scarlet batis or something? What's that guy?
That's the black tiger batis.
Yeah. How long have we had that guy?
Long time. There's six of them in there.
So he's like full grown and that shrimp's bigger than him.
I think that's
or she.
The,
yeah, I guess
he's the male's behind. But the males don't have all their color yet, so they'll still grow a little bit.
Huh. So on the other side of where we're just laying on the floor, what do we got in here?
Those are Cichlids, blackfin, jumbos.
So the jumbos, I've never kept jumbos. How big do they actually get? Is it really like 7 inches or something stupid?
No. I mean, it'll probably be like 4 inches, 5 inches.
Because I feel like other ones get to like 4 inches almost.
Yeah, I don't know about the whole jumbo thing, so we'll see how big they get, but they're definitely bigger bodied as far as how, you know, wide they are.
Lighting it with a stingray, and then...
There's also the Paracyprichromis blue neon.
Yep.
This is where they'll all end up. All my blue neons will end up in here.
And then you've got those xenotilapia guys. Is it xenotilapia misogynes? Is that which ones they are? Or?
Yeah, if that's how you pronounce it. I know how it's spelled, but I don't know how to pronounce it.
Yep, so I'm not saying I know how to pronounce it, I just...
It's not the Calise, it's the other
one. Yeah, the ones that start with an M.
Yeah.
I just say misogynes, and then people go, yeah! I don't think anyone... Well, obviously someone on YouTube knows how to say it, but...
Is that one holding?
Yeah, it looks like it.
The blue neon?
Yep.
Nice.
Indeed.
I like to see that.
Mouth full of babies. How many are they spitting at a time?
I've never got more than four, except the last one, I got 11.
Wow. You change food or anything before you get to that 11, or?
Nope, I have no idea how that happened.
Hmm.
And I've never, I mean, some people say that they'll get up to 10 sometimes, but I've never seen it until now.
Wow, if you look through this tank, it's the back of another 55, and it's like Pleco heaven back there, apparently. Like a bunch on that wood right there. Must be breeders in there?
Yep.
So there's a lot of guppy grass too. All right, now I do have to get up. We got more tanks to look at. All right, another 40 breeder low stand. With what kind of like? I guess I'm trying to formulate the question. What light is that?
I got it off Amazon. It was labeled a PAR 38.
Yeah, so if you search Amazon for a Par 38, a lot of people use it for saltwater, like nano saltwater tanks.
Mm-hmm.
I was just trying it out to see if it gave them better color.
And do you think it does give better color on something else, or?
Yes.
All right.
But I have it too high off this tank.
Okay.
But if you get it down towards the tank, it does make them look better.
And then what fish do we have in here? Like some Trophius of some type.
Trophius and Conde and Condi yellow.
Hmm.
They're just now starting to color up.
Still pretty small.
And then the other guys.
Those are Lion's Cove things?
Sinnoh, tilapia, Lion's Cove.
Yeah, I didn't know that fish when I got here. I just realized you're not shy of your flower pots. That's your favorite cave, apparently. I mean, they work great. I've used them a ton. And the best sand in the world. I'm going to create a run on this sand. Like, all of a sudden, it's going to be like, well, how'd sand get so expensive? Aquarium co-op's a dumbass. Now, this tank will be amazing in about 6 months when stuff starts breeding.
Yes.
Not that it's not amazing now, but I'm just... and see what it's going to grow into. I love the fact that you've got the algae growing on the rock so that the Trophius can graze on them, like that one's doing right there. Let's go do it again.
Yep.
That's how you know you're keeping Trophius right, when you're growing enough algae for them to actually pull it off. So most people bloat their Trophius out by not giving them that natural roughage, in my opinion.
Luckily, so far, I haven't had to deal with that.
Yeah, knock on wood for sure.
Those are the first Trophius that I've kept, so we'll see how it goes.
Nice. I just brought Trophius into my fish room, actually. Just some Debosia, but it was like last week or something.
Yeah, I thought you were looking for E. coli.
I still want E. colis. They're not selling them on the list or anything, and then that local guy doesn't seem to be selling any, so I got antsy, and I was like, I need to play with something. You know, that'll tie me over till I find the E. colis, because I've never done E. colis. I've done Trophius, but not the E. colis, so... All right, I got to stand up, but that tank's coming next. It's fully planted with duckweed. What's up? All right, we got off the ground. It took us 20 minutes, so that's what you don't know. It was a two-hour journey. But what do we got going on in here?
So this is a 30-gallon long with a Phoenix Ray 2.
I'll point out, by the way, you fit the 30-gallon long on the double stand. Nice.
There's whitefin tetra. These are the emerald rainbows.
Wamanensis. Yeah, those things.
That's a rare one. A couple years.
Yeah, that's a. You're looking at this fish on YouTube right now, going, oh yeah, that's something. But go look up the Wamanensis rainbow full grown. You'd be like, oh, turns out I need to buy some of those.
Pisagramma inca. There's the male.
Yeah.
Pair that I got from you.
And I originally got them from Ted Judy. So that's a shout out to Ted Judy.
That's a good source.
Yeah. Doing well. You guys saw my fish room. I could not get these things to breed. They just hate my life. So whatever I do, I don't know if they bred for you yet, but they hated me. Yeah.
I need to probably use some more live food.
Yeah, that's... Yep. Lots of pogo stem and stellatus. That's the big plant. And then he's got the pests that everyone hates. Not only does he have duckweed, but he's got this bladderwort stuff, too.
Yeah, it's very frustrating.
Which, like, 5-6 years ago, people were selling that. And now we know it's like, oh, geez. I don't even know anything it eats it or anything. So it's almost like you gotta tear that tank down if you ever want to get rid of it. But it's fine for breeding, I guess.
Well, it's all caught up in the stem, so I'll probably just rip all that out.
Mm-hmm. I've tried that, but there's always, like, it's like that... Stargrass, you have a problem with, you'd be like, dang, it's still in there. But more Phoenix lights. You have about as many Phoenix lights as I do, almost. Married up to it.
I'm a fan.
Stirbys. I need every tank in my fish room to have stirbys. I feel inadequate. I've got Cichlids and stirbys in one tank. It's like the oddest couple ever, but it works for now. I haven't bred the stirby in there yet, but.
That's a 90 gallon, but I don't fill it up all the way because there's a drain plug on the left.
Oh. So. Have you ever drained out that plug on accident?
Actually, no.
Okay.
But I've overflowed many of tanks, so...
just not that one. And what do we got going on down here?
This is just a bunch of various grow-outs. They're
blue dolphins, there's a redfin, lithobates red top, I don't know if I pronounced that right. Some lithobates blue torpedo blue, which they don't have their colors yet, but like that long skinny one going across the front, that's one of them. Probably some other stuff. There's some Victorian fry, the Rudy Island fry in there.
Okay.
Lots of keys keeping them from beating each other down. That's nice. But it's super easy to clean that tank.
Yep. Anything, this sand with cichlids is, I mean, I rarely have to clean it because they're always moving the sand. Mm-hmm. So they're always stirring it up for me.
Yeah, I mean, it's, I run a lot of tanks and that's my preferred substrate. I fell in love with that 8 years ago or something. It's never looked back. It's amazing.
And then you're going to want to look down that tube.
All right, I'm going to get my camera off my hand here and see if I can...
If you can. If not, I'll reach in there and move it.
Oh, the zebras?
Yep.
I didn't know you had zebras. Nice.
Those were my secret project.
Yeah, I guess now it's... There's three of them in there? How many's in there?
There's six total in the tank. I don't know how many in the tube.
Posters, because everyone always asks me... Where do you buy your posters? I want to buy posters. So where'd you get the shrimp one?
Amazon.
Amazon? Okay, I've never looked on Amazon. I looked on eBay and Aquabid, but I almost bought this poster. I don't have this one yet, but how much was it roughly?
They're $15.99 prime shipping.
Hey, that ain't bad. And then did you get the Pleco one as well?
Yep.
Nice. The best part is you got to frame them, because without the frame, they're nothing, but that frame, I bet you, was more expensive than the...
The frame was $40.
Yeah. Because I frame stuff, and I'm going, man, those are good-looking frames you got there.
Frame also from Amazon, and I'm waiting for another frame to come in, because I've got another one, which is the plants.
Nice.
Which is the hardest one to get. I waited like 3 months.
Huh. I didn't know that was, one of the harder ones to get. But, yeah, it definitely adds a layer to a fish room when you've got posters. You know. All right, well, that's Bob's fish room. He hangs out in Washington Fish Box if you want to come hang out with us. He's going to redo this room. If he does, we're going to film it. You can see, like, oh, man, turns out at 2 years he kept this level. At 3 years, he's a badass. Not that he's not a badass now. Let's be real. But he's already breeding some kind of cool, not kind of cool stuff, cool stuff that's hard to breed. He's dabbling zebra plecos. Make sure you check out the other videos. I want to get this guy, and this is put him on the spot, I want to get him on the live stream someday just to hang out and talk about, people who can ask him about his fish room, because he's local to me. I should say that. He's 15 minutes away from my house, so it's not like I traveled the world to bring you this fish room, so I can come in and check on it anytime we want. He is a subscriber to the channel, so if you leave comments on this video, he can answer them. So totally ask all the questions. Hey, what was that thing? Hey, you said you need to look up the name on that. Do all those things. And we'll see you in the next video. We appreciate you guys hanging out with us for the day.